We are here in Sandy Shores,
Central
for some firefighting duties. So, this currently is saying it's an ambulance, which is not correct. So, what we're going to do is we're going to vehicle options, and we're going to go to livery menu, which I can't see. Oh, there it is. And we're going to be the fire and rescue service. Here we go. So, we're going to, for the first time that we've been a firefighter, we're going to dig into the night shift, and let us go ahead and get some cronies out of the fire station. So it's Jay, isn't it? Yes, it's Jay. So, we've got here somebody in high viz, an incident commander. Now, that's unfortunate. In fact, is it M? There's a thing? No, okay. There's a way to release your pet. So, we can't change that, but unfortunately we've got somebody from SART. Which we didn't want. We would want another firefighter. But that's not going to be something we can change. And we've got an incident commander. And actually, I don't know if the helmet colour is fully random or not. But I like the way that's turned out, because the SART guy's got the green helmet. And Hi-Viz has got the crewman's helmet, which is correct. And the officer has the officer's white helmet, which is quite correct. So that wasn't intentionally by design, but it's worked out quite nicely. We are basically going to have to go along with the SART guy because of the way that the game works. Yeah, so that's a thing. So, they will just behave like a regular firefighter, because that's all it is. Ooh.
1.1.0.
We've got
other
a call.
Fire unspecified. Other fire. Location. Delamo C. Street. Marina Drive.
Okay, so we've got fire at the Alamo C. So what we want here, get rid of that. So we're going to go to model the clothes menu. We've got turnout, which means we need to get ourselves our helmet. And let's go. So we'll hide the information. Everybody's gonna pile in. And the incident commander is not taking shotgun for some strange reason. Anyway, Sandy Shores for the rescue. So I'm kind of not yet at a point with my GTA development that would allow me to kind of show off a lot more things that I want. I want more fire engines and more ambulances in the game, but I've not got them in at the moment, so we're back riding with the deaf. Okay, so it's just at this junction here. Don't see any signs of fire. Oh, okay, so it's a small ooh, that's actually oh crap, we hit a rock. I thought it was a driveway. Whoops. Right. Well, let's get out. And let's just hope that bell end hasn't taken the doors off. Anyway, we'll get the fire extinguisher. So it's just... So they're going to tackle that one. We'll take out the fence. Alright, good stuff. Good stuff. Right, let's go tackle this. No fires on the outside, but we've got quite a lot of carbon fuel on this here fire. I was quite curious about that terminology, actually, because when I went for my fire station visit when I went for a fire station visit at McDonald Road, they used the terminology of a carbon fire. I'd never heard it before, obviously, as you probably are well aware. I'm not a firefighter, so I don't have all that much experience with this thing. I'm quite curious as to why the fire extinguisher isn't making a noise. I'm sure it used to. Anyway, we were supposed to put ourselves. So what do we need to do? So on site. Yeah. Okay. Right. That's fine. Oh, incident commander's on our side. Okay, the fire's actually been put out now, which is fine and dandy. So what we're gonna do is gonna put us to return to station. At McDonald Road, they've got a training facility which is basically a mock ship. because they used to do kind of marine fire brigade stuff, which was all pretty cool. And they basically made they were talking about the fact that they weren't allowed to do carbon fire training anymore. And I was like, what the fuck is carbon fire training? But all it means is fire with actual burnable materials. So now they have to use gas fires, which are easier to put out. And, well, some people feel that that's not the kind of best preparation for dealing with a real emergency. But it is also safer, because the problem with carbon fires, real carbon fires, is that it's quite easy to have them go out of control if you aren't particularly prepared. And even if you are prepared, they can be unpredictable. So I think that's the logic behind it. But they've obviously picked it, chose to do that for a good reason. And yeah, I thought that was interesting. So yes, carbon fire, something that's actual burnable. Speaking of burnable, this looks all pretty damn wrecked. Also, I don't know what you're doing. I think we were holding something. Okay. Should probably indicate on. Right, well, we're back. No. What on earth am I doing? Sorry, buddy. I was about to drive and going forwards, so like, what? Okay, so. We're back in our bay. Excellent. Okay, fine. So, the button is 6. Yeah, so we're back at the fire station, so we can probably go ahead and take our helmet off. Huzzah! So, yeah, it's nighttime, lovely clear skies here in Los Santos, and we've got the training facility around the back, so the horrible thing about sandy shores is you can't tell where the fire station training ends and the poverty begins, because even the fire station, I mean, it's not exactly a well spruced up station. But this is part of our training facility, as you can tell by the burn marks and the fire hydrants everywhere. So this is the fire training facility, and then this is the kind of yard for doing rescue. Also got some spare vehicles loaded in there, and yes, excellent. So, I wonder what we can do for some fun around here. So, one thing I've noticed, seeing as we do have some free time to chat, one thing I've noticed is actually the surprising lack of development of any kind of emergency mod for GTA 5. So, I was, obviously there's the two different mods that I use. There is this mod, which is the Firefighter Mod, or more technically correct, the Mod de Sapi Pompier, the French mod. And the benefits of this one is it allows you teammates, it allows you to go to places like the airport, Sandy Shores, Fort Zucano, and Polito Bay. The other one is the rescue mod, which I've actually not done a firefighter episode on in quite a while. It doesn't have any of that. You're limited to 3 stations in central Los Santos. And it's not been developed since 2015 was the last update for it. I was quite surprised, because while I was on holiday, I went checking to see if there was any updates to any of the mods, and there wasn't. And I was like, eh? And nobody's been building them, so there's no up-to-date paramedic mods. Even this mod, the firefighter mod, it is starting to get a little bit dated, actually. Yeah. Well, hopefully somebody picks up the baton soon. I know there's a few people who I'd love to see make the mod, but I don't own them. Oh, that's interesting. I wonder why you start running when you're in your first person, but you walk. Yeah, that's strange. Also, I don't actually have a head. I'm just a collar. that's funny. Anyway, so what's the time? Time is 11 o'clock. So after the first fire, there is now nothing else to deal with. I want to make sure Aha! So we didn't click ourselves available. That was why we weren't getting a bloody call. Okay, fair enough. Oh well, may as well just chill out in the fire station. So everything is, everything's alright with the appliance here. Is this a jukebox? That's cool. And everything's fine and dandy with the appliance. Actually, I've got a question. I do indeed have a question. Let's just mount into the mortar for a second. We're gonna pull it round to the side. I was just curious because unlike the firefighter rescue mod for GTA 4, there is no fire hose option. It is just fire extinguishers. There's a fence there. Yeah, that's going to technically be. All right, let's do this with precision because we've already dented the damn fire truck. Yes. Glorious. Anyway, for God's sake, I've got the menu mod because I've been testing out a couple of map mods, and every time you press F3, it goes to the free cam. I really need to disable that. Oh, crap.
0.0 fired. Shop on fired. Location.
Wait, how did we get facing the wrong way?
Street. Alhambra Drive.
Oh, hang on. If I do. Aha, right. Okay, there we go. Right, anyway, we've got a fire, so this will have to wait. So, let's go to en route to the fire. So blue lights on, thing off. It's further along here. So it's past the police station. Man, these LEDs look good at night. Look at this. Oh God, it's next to a petrol station. Specifically, where is it? Oh Christ. Right, okay, we could probably do a fire service backup here. And I don't know which one it is.
Requested means police.
No, that's police.
Progress.
So it's 8. No, 9. 9.
Police request done. One unit rose to your intervention.
Right, okay.
Requested means
ambulance. For God's sake, okay, so it must have been 8. Right, anyway, what we want is we're going to get
ambulance
ourselves into
done.
Our helmet
to your intervention.
And change up
requested
our accessory.
Fire reinforcement in progress.
And because it's dark, I'm just going to I'm going to change us into
fire
high
reinforcement
fizz.
Request done.
Right.
One
okay.
Fire engine rose to your intervention.
So we've got police and fire and everything coming. So we just need to start doing the fire. Now I'm going to take the right hand side on the simple basis. Who's turned up? Is anyone turning up? Here's ambulance. There's fire, but they're going away.
Ambulance reinforcement on site.
Cool. Right, anyway. Okay. Because I don't want this fire spreading to the petrol station, if that is even a feature that is possible. So this is fire turning up. Oh, and they've just taken the ambulance off. Okay, fair enough. There's a bit of a fire on the roof, but we'll deal with that in a bit. But there's a wee bit of smoulder on the brickwork. Head round the back. Hit out here. Okay. Another siren? Okay, so the police are still roaming. There's fire. I don't really know what the firefighter is doing. Okay, well, the other fire crew are here. Oh, I wonder, is this a mod that has... yeah, okay, right, so the helmet's still a little bit borked. I think people are having fun with somebody around the side. In the meantime, Christ, who's in their motor? Somebody's in their motor. In the meantime, we've got this fire to put out, and we seem to be the only person actually doing anything. So we've got the wall. So we're in our breathing apparatus, which is fine. We've got somebody approaching us. going to get himself in a heap of hurt. So anyway, we're just going to go ahead and continue putting out the fire. Why is there a man with a gun? Oh god. Let's get police out again. Jesus. Shazam! What's the thing to change unarmed? There's a button for unarmed. Okay. Alright, so there's a shooty dude here. Guy obviously doesn't like the fire service, so it's very potentially the arsonist. Do we have police backup coming? Oh, this guy's getting close.
It must be dreaming or something.
Maybe we should just go into the burning building, because we're protected, he's not. But this very potentially is our arsonist. Alright, okay. The police are obviously not coming, so we'll go again. I was gonna say, it says the police are here, but no, it's not. It's an ambulance. Okay, well, we'll finish putting up the burning building while the guy seems to be otherwise preoccupied. We should probably have put ourselves as being on scene. However, I noticed a little information window is missing, so I'm wondering if the mod has maybe had a little bit of a collapse to itself. In any case, we still have the fire to put out. And there's quite a lot of shit on fire, actually. So there's lots of burnable material on the tills, so we're just going to try and deal with that. Ah crap, there's a casualty. So one casualty from the fire, which we couldn't really deal with because we've been hampered by the bell end with the goddamn gun. God, we must have been at this fire for a couple of hours now. Yeah, we have. Right, anyway, there's still a lot burning, so there's still shelves on fire. I thought we should probably check. Yeah, okay, so the shelf is still smouldering. Let's get this out. You know what the scary thing is? When you look at the graphics and stuff and what you're able to do with these mods, and it's scary because I've not had a chance to test it out, but I know Top Mods has scripts built into one of their vehicle mods that lets you do various things. And it's like, God, you have to think that you're only one dedicated modder away from giving something like Notrop 112 or certainly some of the preceding simulators a run for their money. Of course, Rockstar will probably shut you down, but it seems perfectly feasible to me as a person who can only make something look slightly different. Speaking of slightly different, why the hell won't you go out? Aha! There we are. Okay, so we'll put this out. So everything on the inside seems to be, now can we go through this? No. Everything on the inside is now put out, which is the main thing. Oh, I knocked over the incident commander. Okay, so we need to... I have a wanted level. You fucking what? If anything, the other firefighters who have hatcheted people should be the ones with the wanted level. Let's just fix that before any stupid stuff happens. Anyway, right, the building's still on fire, which is a problem. Who's shooting at us? Not the police. Some random dude. Alright, so we're pinned on the roof because of shooty dude. Can the police just come here? No? No? Maybe? Yes, okay, so I think the police are coming to deal with this guy. Yep, police are here. Move. So, yeah. Yeah. Oh, God. He was trying to come up after us. Alright, fair enough. Fair enough. Anyway, we're actually now a lot of the way through our shift, because we went on at 6 o'clock at night, and it's 4:30 in the morning, so there's only a couple of hours left. In any case, the mod has, in fact, crashed.
Code 1.1.0. Other fire unspecified. Other fire.
Is that in the same place?
Grand
oh, no, it's not.
Desert.
Okay.
Joshua Road.
Well, I was just about to say we're back at the station after having to restart the game to allow it to do Borky stuff, but seeing as we're all in here, we may as well head up over to the main road. Ah, road's clear. So, we're going to a fire. We don't know what kind of fire it is, we just know it's unknown as the morning breaks here in San Andreas. So we've actually only got an hour left of our ship. Our ship has sailed. No, we've only got an hour left of our shift. So here's hoping this is a reasonably quick to deal with fire. And also that we don't have any yokels trying to murder stab us. Let's avoid the guy in the quad bike. So this little rundown establishment here. Ooh, crap. It's got explodey stuff on the roof. Okay. It's a building, so we'd probably best radio in for some assistance.
Reinforcement in progress.
So hopefully these guys... Ah, the helmets haven't paired up this time. He's got a green helmet.
Fire reinforcement request done. One fire engine goes to your intervention.
Right, okay. So, now that that's done. So while these guys are off fighting fires... Oh no. Okay, well, now they come back. Anyway, what I want to do... I really need to change that bloody thing, F3, so we'll go there. Okay, so I want to go to vehicle options, and then
requested
there's a door.
Fire reinforcement in progress. Fire reinforcement on site.
Excellent, so we've got more firefighters
fire
here.
Fire reinforcement request refused, not no units available.
So what I want to do is there no way to open up the hood and trunk? Yes, okay, that's what I wanted. So, we've now got the pump doors open for putting out fires. Also for putting out fires, I need to go ahead and get myself into my firefighting kit. So,
requested means.
No, I don't want another fire engine, for God's sake. Oh, there goes the fire engine. Right, so we're gonna put...
Fire reinforcement request refused, not no units available.
That's fine. So anyway, we've got one fire crew on here, and we're going to put on our...
Requested means fire reinforcement in progress.
Firefighting gear. Excellent. Okay, fine. So...
Fire reinforcement request refused, not no units available.
Oh crap, there's a fire at my feet. Damn, Sean. Alright, okay, well, we're over the fence, we've got our extinguisher on, I'm in breathing gear. We have all appropriate apparatus connected up to the appliance. I guess we should probably say that we were on site. There we go. Right, okay, so there's no more fire on the outside. Oh, God. Well, that could have been nasty if the fire had hit that propane tank. But there's no more fire along this end of the building, so as we go into overtime... We've basically only got this little bit of fire left to put out. In fact, is there anything on the roof? There was an explosion on the roof, so we probably need to survey that. Okay, there's nothing smouldering. There's nothing outside. Yeah, I agree. We'll head up there. Yeah, okay, good chap. So he's already on it with his fire extinguisher. And it was the air conditioning unit that we saw blow up, so potentially the cause of this. If it had maybe been left to run while nobody was there. No matter, because the fire is now dealt with, so... Now else to do, but to head off. So the second crew, which will probably have come along from Polito Bay. So Polito Bay is a two-pump fire station, we're just a one-pump fire station. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna remove our fire gear and take off our hat, which is fine. And we're gonna fire off back into here. Wait, what? Why are we getting out? No, get back in. Oh, my phone's going off. Okay, it's nothing. It's absolutely nothing. So, all that's left
means fire reinforcement in progress.
God, there needs to be a way of stopping that. Okay, vehicle options.
Fire reinforcement request refused. Dot no units available.
Yes, quite aware. The intervention is done. Crap, I've got one bullet. So we're gonna go to and we're gonna close all vehicle doors, which is fine. And there we go. We're done. So the mod is not perfect. I really need to start adding modifiers to the keys, so that you have to press like shift or something to get the have you got a flat? Ah, crud, we do. Alright. We'll have to pull off. So yeah. We've got a flat tire. Great! So we're gonna need recovery to come and oh crap. And we lost the door. So we need recovery. So yeah, what a way to end the shift. The I can hear a siren somewhere. So yes, the Sandy Shores fire station is out of a fire appliance because we have a flat. So we need to go back to this. Well, we need to get towed back to the station so we can change the tire. So even though our shift is over, it well and truly is the end of our time today with the San Andreas Fire and Rescue Service. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.